We continue to gather information about Omar Mateen to learn why he carried out his deadly attack. The 29-year-old was an American-born Muslim who worked as a security guard in Florida. He bought two guns legally within weeks of his deadly rampage, and Mateen's ex-wife attributed the violence to mental illness, saying he was bipolar.
This noon, people in Metro Atlanta are creating a way to remember the victims. Channel 2's Linda Stover continues our live Team 2 coverage in Midtown Atlanta at 10th and Piedmont, where people are coming by. Linda?
That's right. People are coming here just to stop for a moment and remember. Let me step out of the way so you can see the dozens of candles swirled around this parking lot in tribute to the men and women killed in Orlando. People are stopping by to light a candle. Some pause, pray, or take a picture of the rainbow colors in this parking lot where the wax is actually melting into the pavement now. Last night at 10th and Piedmont, a large crowd came to show support and stand with Orlando. Hundreds of people, some gay, some straight, chose to send a message of love. Today, this is a spot, a special place for anyone to stop and reflect on the horror of what happened in the nightclub, and also really the best way to deal with it. And as we come back out here live, I can tell you that a lot of these flames are still burning right now, even in the daylight. This memorial, this tribute is so large, it's hard for a car to actually get through the parking lot right now, but people in the area we talked to today say for now, that's a beautiful thing. Live in Midtown Atlanta, Linda Stover, Channel 2 Action News.